everyone. And good evening, everyone. I'm Scott Eisenhower, along with Bob Kay from the NJCAA Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament. We get set for our national anthem prior to our starting lineups. Game number 3 of this tournament between Rose State and Wabonzi.
Shortest trip of the tournament, Bob Kay. Of course, the first would obviously belong to Danville Area Community College. Wabonzi, also a representative from the state of Illinois. Illinois is the only state that has two teams represented in this national tournament.
This is true, and we've seen some really good teams come down from that northern area. Joliet won it in 1994, and second place went to DuPage, College of DuPage. So we've seen some awfully good teams come from that northern division.
As we get set, the Raiders will be in their traveling blue uniforms, trimmed in golden and white, while the Chiefs in their home gold uniforms, trimmed in red and in white. Off the tip, a quick flip from Griffo out of bounds, and the Chiefs start the contest by giving it over to Rose State immediately. And the Raiders of Rose State College will enter the forward court for the first time. To the right hand side, they work the ball to the side.
Pass inside, goes inside to Ogilvy. He turns. Shoots. In the backcourt, the Chiefs trying to get it in the backcourt. Saxon across court to Thompson. Thompson in the paint. Thompson inside. Osland is shot, no good. Ogilvy. State to the right hand side. They work the Lang. Lang out beyond the perimeter. Looking up top and now feeds up top. Ogilvy. Left hand side, McCleary. His shot on the way. Too hard. The side rim. Rebound put back, no good. It's Watford inside. Will be Wabonzi, and Tim Heiss wants a timeout. It'll be a 4-0 lead by the Raiders of Rose State College.
Scott, I think the coach of the Chiefs was not happy at all about the lack of rebounding down there at the offensive end. That he called a timeout very quickly, 18:35 to go in the first half. And I think his point's going to be he wants a little bit better effort on the rebounding, and we'll have to see where they go from there.
And a quick prelim of this contest. People want to know how good Rose State College is. Well, I'll tell you this, Bob Kay. This was the team that eliminated Brown-Mackey College in the district tournament, and Francis Flax, the National Coach of the Year last year, and of course, Brown-Mackey, the national champions last year. Coach thought this year's team was better.
Rose team is very, very quick. I watched him in practice and here in the first 2 minutes. Extremely quick on the floor.
Derek Lang is going to pick up the first personal foul, the first against the Rose State College Raiders. And Wabonzi will inbound underneath their own. They get it inside. The Rose State has the shot. The ball is going to be picked up by Rose State. To the right-hand side. They work over to the corner. Pearson. Pearson with the ball. Now works up near the top of the arc. Dumps off to Coleman. Coleman to the left-hand side. Works to Lang. Lang feeds to Pearson. Pearson will pull up. Shoots. The bucket is good. 7-0. The lead by the Raiders of Rose State College. Chiefs with the basketball. Looking for some offense. Picking up the block is Mike Coleman. He also picks up the personal foul on the play. It'll be his first, the team's second.
Sure, he got him with his body because he reached over the back on the drive-in and they really hit the ball and knocked it off the bottom of the rim, but must have got him with a body that we couldn't see in through all the mass of players.
Thompson will go to the line, trying to get the lid off of the Wabonzi bucket. And the first one on the way is up and it is good. First point last on the scorebook for both Thompson and the Chiefs of the Wabonzi Community College out of Sugar Grove, Illinois.
Well, Wabonzi, and we'll talk about this maybe a little later on, they had a great football team at their high school, and DJ Luke from Danville coached that football team.
Here's a shot. Second attempt, no good, and the rebound by Rose State. McCleary will push it across the timeline. Off to the right-hand side, works to Pearson. Pearson with the ball. Up top and around. Again, they go to McCleary. Underneath the Ogilvy. McCleary. McCleary holds on the cross court, gives to Lang. Lang will now work it back out near the State of Illinois market mid-floor. Left-hand side, McCleary. Top of the key, Coleman. His shot from the rebound range won't go. The shot clock at 3, Lang shot off the front of the rim, no good, rebound by Wabonzi. On the outlet to the right-hand side, Sykes. Sykes to the right-hand side to the forecourt, now dumps off into the corner to Osler. Osler back up top, Richardson. Richardson stops, holds. Gives to Osler. Osler to Richardson, his shot on the way is too bad. And the Raiders to the right-hand side, and up the floor they come. On the drive, Lang dumps it down underneath the
Brown Mackey. They got a lot of speed and a lot of quickness.
To the left-hand side, gives the ball to Pearson. Pearson shoots the three ball, missed it on the front of the rim, and the rebound by the Chiefs. To the west end of the gym we go. Sykes on the drive, plays it on the glass and scores. He's got his first two.
went coast to coast. Had a man open on the right, didn't pass to him. I think he knew when he crossed the timeline he was going to drive and either get the basket or get fouled.
9-3, the lead by Rose State. And now we've got an official's timeout, or is it going to be a whistle? It's going to be a whistle away from the ball, and it's going to be against Wabonzi. That'll be Irving Lucas picking up his first and the team's first.
I got three turnovers right now for the Chiefs from Wabonzi and none on Rose at the early going.
To the right-hand side off the inbound, they bring it to Lang. Lang with the basketball, now works up top and around the perimeter. Pearson dribbles and hands to McCleary. McCleary, right-hand side, a three-pointer on the way. And ball. Rebound by Rose. And he'll go to the line to shoot two. That foul is on Marcus Sykes. It'll be his first and the team's second. Good crowd from both of us here tonight. We've got directly behind us the folks from Wabonzi down the Ray. Good contingency from Rose State. And the first three points up and good by Derek Pearson. That's his third point in the ball game. Ogilvy with four.
David Pearson looks like he could be running back. Pretty good build on him.
Second free throw on the way. And it's an 11-3, 8-point lead for Rose State College. Out of Oklahoma in the fourth quarter. With the ball, Lang has it stripped away. Rose State trying to save it in bounds, and they skip it to each other, who were both standing out of bounds. Lang and McCleary were both standing out of bounds, and McCleary got the pass from Lang and realized it didn't make any difference at that point. They were both standing outside the playing surface. Turnovers by the Chiefs. Up top, McCleary works off to the right-hand side for Rose State. Lob down deep into the corner to Pearson. Pearson dribbles outside the arc, trying to get it into Ogilvy. It's going to be picked off. The second turnover by the Raiders. With the steal. Now to the right-hand side. And by the Pearson down. Hold the ball's on Rose State is going to make the steal. Holman there to pick the pocket. Works it off right-hand side. Lang in the forecourt, over the inside, they give, down
the ball. Scott, there's some ball handling and passing there. Pass to a man on the baseline. He really didn't have a very good shot and had the awareness to see the man coming right down the middle. Got a little, each pass was about 3 feet. Those are difficult to handle because you're in so close. Yeah, but both of them were perfect right at the hands and above the head. Real good passing and good teamwork.
Coleman will go to the line and try to complete the three-point play. 14:45 left to go in the first half. 13-3, the lead, and the missed opportunity for Rose State to increase that 10-point advantage. Wabonzi with the rebound and up the floor. They got Flint to the left-hand side. Gives to Flint. Flint down low, now back up. To Flint, to Flint, right-hand side. They work it to Oslin. Oslin on the cross court, wide open, baseline jumper, off the mark for Flint. Rebound loose on the floor, and Rose State picks it up. That shot there was what happens when you're in a national championship tournament, 5K, and the butterflies get to your tummy a bit.
Yeah, he didn't have that good wrist flick on that. He just kind of threw it up there. I used to say, throwing a shot put up there.
Missed opportunity for Derek Lang, and Wabonzi with the rebound. To the left-hand side they work. Up top it comes, and around the perimeter. They get to the right-hand side. Brown dumps down low. Jumper on the way, and the fadeaway good for Eric Grippo. He's got his first 2 points. 13-5, the lead belongs to Rose State. Out to the right side. On the dribble, McCleary to the left-hand side and around the perimeter. They work to Pearson on the baseline drive. Shoot scores!
Good body control, got up in the air, got a defender from the Chiefs on him, and he almost passed out, Scott. He almost passed the man in the corner and didn't realize he did have a good layup. He went ahead with the shot.
Wabonzi with the ball. Flat on the bounce pass inside the paint. Turnaround jumper on the way. No good for Osley. Rebound put back. Partially blocked. again with the putback. Grippo's second effort does not go through, but he's fouled this time and will head to the line to shoot two.
Well, Grippo didn't make either one, but he showed great hustle on the board. He missed the first one. Probably got fouled on that one. Went right back up and got it again and put it up. And this time he did get fouled, but good effort on the boards.
Well, if you're Dave Heist, though, that's the one thing you don't want to see is the big man inside have offensive opportunities and not capitalize.
Yep, if he'd got that second one to go down and had a chance for the three-pointer.
And the free throw by Grippo is no good. We have one of the most educated coaches in the country involved in this contest, Dr. Thomas Mills, the head coach of the Raiders of Rose State College, and I think his doctorate degree is in microbiology.
Well, I'd say that he's well qualified in that area. And if he's got a team in the final eight, I'd say he's well qualified in that area.
Second free throw also no good, and the rebound by the Raiders off to the right-hand side. McCleary with the basketball. Up top, he works it to Ogilvy. Ogilvy off to the left-hand side. Gives it to Johnson. Johnson will hand off to Lang. Lang down underneath. Ogilvy has the ball.
Let me ask you this, my man. You've had him under the water, under the den, under the... If he's got a doctorate in microbiology, can he dissect this game on his own?
Easily.
Okay.
More ways than we'll ever know.
Yeah, I think you're right.
That foul is on Brian Flynn. It'll be his first, the team's fourth, and at the charity stripe, Ogilvy. Looking for his fifth point, and he gets it. Pearson with six, Coleman with two, McCleary with three.
Well, and we'll see here if, they just told him to put his shirt in. That, at the banquet last night, that was one of the things that must have shirt tails in. The guy just came into game. Thompson had his shirt tail out, but he was warned.
And he makes a second free throw. He's got 6 points. So Armin High School on hand, serving as our pep man for this contest. Meanwhile, Labonte down by 12, 17-5 with the ball. Into the paint, they'll throw it up. Up the glass and good for Brian Flynn, and he's got his first 2 points. 12:33 left to go here in the first half. A 10-point advantage for the Raiders of Rose State College. McCleary on the right-hand side is going to take it to the baseline. Now dribbles up top to Ogilvy. Ogilvy in the lane, throws it up, misses it. And he's going to be fouled into the charity stripe for two freebies.
You might say that while we got this chance on the waiting for the free throws to be shot, that the national anthem was played by Ronell Morsi, a Charmin student, played it on the trumpet, played very well. That'd be scary in front of a crowd, be a young high school student, have to play a solo.
Ogilvy with his first free throw attempt is good. He's got 7 points. 18-7, the 11-point Raider lead.
Well, Rose early, and it's still early with just eight minutes in the game. It's got, it seems, their forte, and not only speed, but his defense holding Labonte to 7 points.
Ogilvy gets them both. He's got 8 points. Chiefs almost threw it away again. Richardson with the ball. Gives inside. Flynn has it knocked out of play, and it was last touched by the Raiders. It'll come back to the Chiefs underneath their own.
That was real close to being, he got in there and couldn't shoot it and passed one of his men, or almost one of his own men.
Off the inbound, they work the ball into the hands of Plank, and he misses the three-point opportunity. They'll stay with the basketball. To the right-hand side, they give to Lang. Lang out beyond the arc. Dishes it up top, Ogilvy to the right-hand side, McCleary. McCleary rolls across the top of the arc. Now hands to Johnson. Johnson has a beat out of bounds on a nice defensive hustle by Irving Richardson. The ball will come back to the Raiders over on the right-hand side of the forecourt.
Good hands down there by Dave Heist, the Labonte coach, who was squatted down like a catcher, caught that deflected pass. No trouble.
And now a steal by the Chiefs. They'll work it into the forecourt, up to the right-hand side. Three Rose State College turnovers. Thompson gives the ball up to Plank. Plank works it to the left-hand side, Brown. Brown around the perimeter, Thompson, Plank. Left-hand side, Richardson. Richardson on the baseline. Ball to Brown, shot clock at 10. Here's a three on the way. It is no good by Flynn, and a rebound by Rose State. On the outlet bound, they give to the right-hand side. Johnson with the basketball. Works it underneath to Ogilvy. Back to Johnson. Three-pointer attempt. It doesn't fall. Loose on the floor, and the rebound is going to be scooped up by Plank, and will head in the other direction to Wabonzi's forecourt. He'll take it into the paint. Scoop pass goes to Brown. thought somebody would be breaking down the right-hand side of the baseline. Nobody followed his lead. Seven turnovers by the Chiefs of Waubonsie Community College. And that there, Bob K, tells you why they're down by 12.
Yep, that's pretty hard to overcome that and not so good shooting.
Line with the ball to Ogilvie for Rose State. They work out to the left-hand side. McCleary with a three, it doesn't fall. The rebound picked up by Ogilvie, and the Raiders will keep control. Lang with the basketball. Looks down low, gives inside to Ogilvie, has it knocked loose, and Waubonsie with the steal. Four Raider turnovers. 10:30 left to go here in the first half. 19-7, the 12-point Rose State lead. Flint with the basketball, beyond the arc to Plank. Inside they give, and the layup by Thompson is good, and he's got the rebound.
Thompson made a good reverse pivot that time, got the man on his hip, rolled to the left side, and came in, got a good shot.
Out into the left-hand corner, McCleary with the basketball. He on the bounce pass gives to Lang. Lang up top, Ogilvie for a three. Missed it off the front of the rim. Rebound inside by Cole, and he'll clear it out to Lang, and Lang will reset the offense.
Well, Cole, who did not start this game, has come in and kind of taken over the boards.
Here's a shot inside, no good. Bodies everywhere underneath, and now the officials are going to call timeout, and that's just to separate all the bodies that have been sprawled out on the floor. Coming out of the pile, a bit limping, is Richardson.
Well, Richardson got up in the air, Scott, and had nowhere to go because Cole had fallen, and I don't know, no, we don't have a timeout. Cole was the first to hit the floor, and Richardson came down on top of him. He didn't have anywhere else to go.
Well, when Wally Cole fell down, two players came down and just barely missed his head.
Sure did.
Out on the left-hand side, Osley into the forecourt, pulls up, shoots. It is no good off the side of the rim, the rebound by Ogilvie for Rose State. 9:30 left to go in the first half, 19-9, Rose State with the lead. Ogilvie around the perimeter, works it right-hand side to Johnson. Johnson on the dribble, gives left-hand side. Lang, Ogilvie, McCleary, Ogilvie in the paint and crack.
Well, it was a great move, and Ogilvie saw the chance to go down and drive and cut the defense, go right through the defense, but he, before he dribbled, he decided he'd take that long first step.
9:17 to play here in this first half. Five turnovers by Rose State, seven by the Chiefs of Waubonsie Community College. They've got the basketball, Plank in the backcourt. Goes to the right-hand side, works it to Osley. Osley to Plank, and he throws it away. That is a second unforced turnover they have had.
Willie threw it right to the referee. Got into traffic, got into the center, into the free throw area, and into the lane, and turned around, looked out court, saw a man, and threw it to him, and unfortunately it was the referee. And the referee just stepped aside and let it go out of bounds.
McCleary will get the inbound. Now walks it across the green stripe at midfloor to the right-hand side. Comes up top and around the perimeter. They work left-hand corner. Pearson, cover, good! He's got nine.
Derek Pearson, when he gets squared away, he made that first basket of the game. He's a pretty good shooter. Got great form, great release.
22-9, Rose State out on top. Having some trouble at midfloor is Flint. Flint finally rolled back. To do it.
Well, that time he got double teamed wherever he went. He got double teamed the center circle, turn went right, got double teamed at the timeline, and we're going to get a timeout spot.
Dave Heiss wants a timeout. I think it'll be a full. We'll take it. 8:32 left to go in the first half. 22-9. The lead belongs to Rose State College. You're listening to the NJCAA Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Network. Thank you.
first half, 22-9. The advantage belongs to Rose State College. Out on the left-hand side, McCleary with the ball. We'll give it up top to Cole. Wally Cole dishes off right-hand side. Johnson on the cross court, almost threw it into the Sorman High School band. Instead, Pearson comes up with it. Down to McCleary. McCleary down deep into the corner. Works the ball into the hands of Johnson. Johnson dumps down. Low with the layup is good. Wally Cole, and that's his first two.
Excellent pass, passing that time. They reversed the ball, came from the left side around the top and down in the middle to Cole and got the easy layup.
24-9, the lead by Rose State. Labonte down into the paint. Grippo had a shot, passed it up, instead feeds inside to Richardson. And the first goal, he's got two.
Scott, one thing about Rose, and we've watched him for the first 12 minutes or so, boy, their hands are always working on defense, always grabbing, slicing, reaching.
Almost a steal inside by Griffo, and the ball comes right back to McCleary. McCleary out on the right-hand Rose State forecourt, pulls up, shoots, missed the 13-footer, and the rebound by Osley. Osley will kick it out to Flint, Flint to Richardson. Richardson tried to dish it inside the paint, and it was knocked out of play by Robert Johnson.
We talked about Scott earlier in the game. Pearson's made two or three baskets for Rhodes where he squared up, faced the basket, and got good shots at him with his feet under. And this last jump shot on the move, on the run, body was going right toward the out-of-bounds line. The shot was to the left toward the basket. Just didn't square up well and get the good shot.
On the inbound, they bring it inside. Thompson with a turnaround. The bucket is good. He's got five.
Second time Thompson's worked well under the basket, worked to get himself open.
24-13, the advantage belongs to Rose State College. 7 minutes left to go here in the first half. Cleary, low to the left-hand side, dumps it off to Pearson. His shot, no good. Rebound, scooped up by the Chiefs. Franklin pushing across the midcourt stripe. Off to the right-hand side, Thompson. Thompson, now a hold, and gives to Richardson. Richardson to Plank. Plank, out near the midcourt stripe. Gives to Osley. Osley to Richardson. Richardson on the baseline drive. Beats inside. Grippo jumper good. And he's got four. And a 32nd look after Thomas Mills. And he wants to talk to his team and slow him down a little bit, Bob K. They were up at one point by 13. That lead now 24-15, a 9-point spread.
Scott, how many times you and I have worked together over the last 4 or 5 years and we've talked about a big guy in underneath getting the basketball, getting the basketball and bouncing it once before they take the shot. They get the ball, the big guy 6'7", and getting it, bouncing it. That time the pass came in, caught it over his head, put it right back up there, didn't bounce it, and got the good shot.
Boy, and people don't understand the importance of that. And that's where, in all honesty, your very late stages of YBA ball or junior stages of your high school basketball career is all based on fundamentals. And that's where, if you're going to be a person who wants to play in the paint, you need to learn. You catch the ball above your shoulder, you keep it above your shoulder.
We used to, when I helped Norm Held years ago, we used that in a lot of center drills then underneath with a ball that wouldn't bounce. And one of those no-bounce practice balls. And, boy, it's amazing how quick they learn. You put it down there, you're in trouble.
Rose Stain again. How do you control the basketball into their forecourt. They turn it over for the sixth time, and Wabonzi CC up the floor. Here's a missed opportunity by Griffin, and a putback by Thompson. 7 points for Thompson.
Since he's coming to game, he's got him a little beef and under the basket, under the boards.
24-17. The Raiders' lead is cut to 7. Off to the left-hand side. Pearson with the basketball, trying to work it down low. Does so, and the layup is good by Armstrong. First 2 points.
Armstrong knocked the ball to the floor, pushed his man off so he could get to it and laid it up. Oh, we're going to get an offensive step.
Now, Richardson grabbed the basketball and had many choices. He could have either charged, prayed for a foul, or traveled, and he took the lesser of three evils, and that was the travel.
He's going to get a rest also.
5:29 left to go here in the first half. 26-17, the advantage. Rose State, although that advantage has dwindled. Here's a feed down low, into the hands of Coleman. He turns, shoots, scores!
9 turnovers now for Wabonzi.
Out on the left-hand side, Osley with the basketball. Works the plank. Plank with the Wabonzi ball, gives it inside.
trouble. Lost the handle and Rosedale can be in the foul with it. McCleary into the forecourt, to the top of the key, rolls to the right-hand side, and gives to Lang. Lang on the lob, again trying to get it inside to Armstrong, but it was pounded away by the Chiefs and out of play. It'll come back to the Raiders underneath their own bucket.
Good hustle on defense by Eric Griffo that time, didn't get the foul. One of those reaching ins where you really take a chance of getting the foul, did a good job.
To the right-hand side, they bring the ball to Lang. Lang out beyond the perimeter. Kicks upstairs and around. McCleary on the left, holds. Now kicks down deep into the
Pearson had one bad jump shot off the free, off the baseline, but he didn't have body control outside of that. Boy, when he squares up, he's deadly.
On the cross-court pass, Wabonzi gets it into the forecourt. They give the plank to Brown. Brown dumps it off down underneath. Griffin back upstairs, Plank picks the three. Pulls up from the free throw line, dishes it down low on the baseline. Osley had the ball stripped away inside, and a foul is going to be called.
Well, that time Adam Plank did two good things. A ball fake out high on the top of the key and got his man in the air and broke around him. And then gave a great pass down on the baseline. Unfortunately, the guy on the baseline just couldn't hold on to it. But Plank had two good moves on one possession right there.
31-17, the lead belongs to Rose State. Wabonzi will inbound in their forecourt. It goes from Thompson up top to Plank, out of Brown to Plank. Plank across the top of the arc, get down. Himself up near the State of Illinois emblem. Gives to Brown, left hand side, back up top line. To Brown, down underneath Thompson. Thompson spins, clears the ball, and gets the ball.
We got a basket and a knockdown move.
Looked like a construction company in there knocking things out of its way.
He's a force under there.
Start calling him the foreman. Rose State into the forecourt to the left-hand side. McCleary holds the ball. Free throw line extension. Now looks down. Can't find anybody. He'll take it into the paint. Dumps inside with the ball. Coleman turns, shoots. No good. And the rebound by Griffo for Wabonzi. Coming out of the flank. 3:25 left to go here in the first half. 31-19. The advantage by Wabonzi, or Rose State College. Wabonzi with the ball to the left-hand side. They get to Brown. Brown dribbles down near the baseline. Throws it in front of the court. It's picked off by McCleary. One-on-one. McCleary drives, shoots, missed it. Rebound is going to be scooped up by Osley. He'll give down the floor to Richardson. Now to Thompson. Thompson hands it off to Brown. On the baseline, bounce pass gives inside. Thompson shot no good, but the putback is critical by Osley. He's got his first two.
Good second effort rebound by Osley. That time he was on the weak side. Got the long shot hard off the board.
31-21. Raiders out on top with the ball. Rose State pushes to the left-hand side. Woods in between the circles to Pearson. Deep in the corner, McCleary with a three. In and out, doesn't fall. Rebound, tapped around, loose on the floor. We've got a whistle, and this is going to be...
Not sure. It'll be three subs, four substitutes. What's going to be? I think it's somebody was standing on the out of bounds
line. Yeah, that's what they're going to call Coleman on the out of bounds line. And give the ball now to Wabonzi Community College. 2:27 to play here in the half. Coming up at halftime, Bob Kay will be joined by John Spezia, head coach of Dan Valeria Community College, who will be playing in our fourth game of the day. But he also serves as the assistant and associate tournament director. Up to the right hand side. The Chiefs work it down underneath. The layup by Griffo is good. He's got six. 31-23. And it looks as though the Raiders of Rose State have given Wabonzi a wake up call.
They've given him a second breath here.
On the line down low. They get to Ogilvie in the easy layup. He's got 10.
Scott, that was an interesting pass by inside because he stands at 6'4 and he had the height advantage to throw that lob pass.
Richardson on the baseline, missed the shot, rebound Ogilvie. On the outlet, they get to McCleary. McCleary to the left-hand side. Dumps it off. Woods, who almost tried it, feeds it to McCleary, gives to Ogilvie. He'll drive the paint, missed the shot, and the rebound by Wabonzi. Plank with the basketball across the floor. Bounce pass down deep to the baseline. Back to Plank. Plank will take it inside, dumps to Griffo, the layup no good. Rebound, fought for it inside, scooped up by Richardson, the Chiefs with the ball. Second effort no good, and this time Rose State with clear. 1:15 left to go here in the first half. 33-23, the lead belongs to the Raiders
Bulldogs of Rose State College.
McCleary with the ball. Gives to Ogilvie. Dumps it off, right-hand side, three on the way, in and out. Woods, ball, rebound, scooped up by the Raiders. The putback second up for three. Is good. He's got six.
Say one thing for Rose, they shoot the highest jump shots. Maybe not jumping high, but arching the ball. They get them up in the air.
Up to the right-hand side, shoots ball, lagged with it, lost the handle, and scooped up by McCleary. McCleary, one-on-one, up the floor, layup, good. McCleary with eight. 38-23, and with a snap of your fingers, Bob K, Rose State came up big. 12 first half turnovers by the Chiefs of Wabonzi. They'll work it underneath to Griffo. Shot no good, and he's going to be fouled by Ogilvie. And Ogilvie immediately gets to the floor to help Griffo up. These two teams have both shown enormous sportsmanship.
Let's say have good sportsmanship by both teams that time. And Rose is guilty of this because a lot of athletic teams with a lot of athletic ability. They go for the fake, pump fake, and they're in the air flying. And that time, he didn't have anywhere to land except on top of the guy that gave the fake. He's going to be shooting the free throw now. Landed on him, pulled him down, and then helped him up. Was not an intentional foul by anyone.
At the stripe, Griffo. He's got two free throws, and the first one is good. That's his seventh point of the ball game. Thompson with nine, and then you've got Richardson with two, Sykes with two, Osley with two, and Flint with two.
You got balanced scoring, which might give you a more than all those twos.
38-24, 14-point advantage belongs to Rose State. Wabonzi will try to whittle away at that one more time with Griffo at the stripe. This one is up. It is good. Griffo with 8 points. In the backcourt, the ball's almost stolen away, but the Raiders have come up with it. Finally into the forecourt, left-hand side. They work to Johnson. Johnson, near mid-floor, now pulls up. Three-point shot is short off the front of the rim of the rebound by Thompson. Thompson on the outlet feed to Flint. Flint at the buzzer. Good for three! A three-pointer at the buzzer for Brian Flint. He's got five for the half. And going into the locker room, Rose State leads Wabonzi 38-28. Let's take a two-minute break. You're listening to the National Junior College Athletic Association Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Network.
State out on top of Wabonzi. Let's take a look at the individual numbers. First of all, for the Raiders, Sean McCleary with 8 points, Wally Cole with two, Duncan Ogilvy with 10, Derek Pearson with 12, and Mike Coleman with 4. Doug Armstrong with a bucket in the first half. For the Chiefs of Waubonsie Community College, Brian Flint with 5. 3 of those 5 came on a tray at the buzzer to end the half. Donnell Osley with 2, Marcus Sykes with 2, Irving Richardson with 2, Eric Grippo with 8, and Mike Thompson with 9. Again at the break, Rose State leads Waubonsie 38-28. We'll take a 2-minute break when we come back. John Spezia is standing by as our halftime guest. You're listening to the National Junior College Athletic Association Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Radio Network.
To move me to some other lighter duties, and that always helps. You know, we just come off the region tournament, which basically myself and Tim Button run, and you know, that pretty much takes a lot of our time, just 11 teams and that, getting ready for this. And then this one is a year-long process, and you know, you're always in meetings, got different things going. Yeah, it does take some time and away from what you're trying to do, but also it kind of gets you away from focusing just on basketball a little bit. And sometimes you need that as a coach, just to separate that and not just worry about games. You know, and it does that for me. I see a lot of kids play and see some good basketball, and I think that kind of breaks up some of the pressure for us.
John, you won the regional tournament. Now you've got the national tournament this week, and this is the two big weeks of the state and AA basketball. How much time does this take away from your scouting? Does this hurt you in seeing some of the players, or do you get that done earlier?
Well, you know, know, I used to think it did hurt us, and I'm not so sure now. I've always felt when, you know, when you're not someplace and somebody else is, they're going to beat you. But, we try to do a better job of getting more information out there. Rusty Albertson and Mike Carpenter and Kevin Carlton have been out on the road recruiting. Kevin was out in, down by Charlestown, Indiana this last weekend, so we've got that contact, and we've got some other kids made verbal commitments to us. So, yeah, it hurts you somewhat, but this year maybe less because of Rusty and Kevin.
John, how much do you use? I know we talked about you're going to play the next game, the Magatuck Valley game, and that's a long way away in Connecticut, but you said you had a lot of friends and you picked up some scouting that way. How much do you depend on your coaching fraternity for both recruiting and scouting communities?
Oh, quite a bit. You know, I've been in a long time, 18 years here, 25 total. There's a lot of people I know all over the country, and a couple phone calls, I can find out just about if you wear blue shorts, white shorts, you had hearts on your boxer shorts. They're pretty good about that. And now, you know, when you talk to the coaches in the other regions that have been playing those regions, it's a little tougher to get information from those guys. I understand that. Our region's the same way. But, you know, I'm kind of relentless. I'm and persistent. I'm going to find somebody, a four-year coach, or somebody that knows something about those guys. That's how it works. Recruiting the same way. Well, we have a lot of four-year coaches that help us and we keep in contact with, and a lot of alumni. Matt Sisley, that played for us, has brought guys up to us. Of course, obviously, Kevin Carlton, when he wasn't playing for us, he told us about guys. I go through a list of guys and call us and tell us about players. Hey, coach, you need to take a look at this guy, or they'll email me. So, you know, the networking is very important in our business.
John, what if you may have been able to find out what about there's one of your ex-players right there.
Corey Fox,
who played at Western Illinois this year.
What have you found out about Naugatuck Valley?
Oh, you know, they got Sellers is one of the leading scorers in the country. Very good shooter, 6'6", goes to the glass, earning about 12, 14 rebounds a game. They got a big kid inside, Mullen, that's can give you some problems on the glass. Three little guards are very quick. They play a lot of 2-3 zone, 1-3-1. They'll pressure some, though I wouldn't anticipate a lot with only eight guys. I would say, they've got a little size, and, you know, by all means, we're not a physical or a big team. We're a team that relies on our great quickness and defensive intensity. So, you know, we're going to suit it up and do what we have been doing. I don't know that you can make a lot of adjustments this time period. You're going to make a few, but at this stage, you've been doing what you've been practicing, and if you haven't got the job done now, you're in some big trouble, Robert Kane.
I was going to ask you about that. You're reading my mind that this late in the year, if you make many changes or if you just make subtle adjustments.
Just subtle adjustments. It may be we've got the zone repertoire in our, if we have to use a little bit, or we change up with our man-to-man a little bit. And offensively, depending, what they're going to do, we'll make some adjustments with that. A lot of it's personnel adjustments, moving them in different spots and seeing who's hot and who's not. Like a Kenan Roots had a great region tournament. It could be a John Sanders this time. You got to kind of ride with and have a feel for your players and what they're doing and what they're capable of doing. And it could be something else. Oscar Sanders could step up today and be the guy. You know, it's just, and that's what our kids have done. You know, one guy goes down a little bit, the next couple guys pick it up.
John, this is the seventh year here, I believe, at Danville Area Community College for this tournament. What's the biggest, have you seen a big change in the team's players? What's been the biggest change in the 7 years they've been here?
Well,
or has it stayed about the same?
It's pretty much been about the same. I think we had the year there with Kirkwood, wasn't real big and very quick and handled basketball. And you had the year with Mazunovic at Joliet, had some big kids. And I thought last year was, we had a very athletic team in Brown Mackin, maybe one of the most athletic teams that played in the championship game. Of course, we had big size. I think it fluctuates. I don't know. This year, I think the field, there's a lot of good teams here, Bob. I think maybe the best group of teams I've seen in this field.
Right. Last couple of years, there have been one or two teams that you wonder how they got here. I haven't seen that yet today. We haven't seen everybody, but I haven't seen any of that today.
No, I think 1 through 12, you got a pretty good balance and some good players. I don't know if there's any great players like we saw with Alvin Young or the kid from Brown Mackey.
Robinson.
Yeah, Robinson. It's with the Charlotte Hornets. But I think we've got more balance of teams and players.
We got about 20 seconds left. What's the biggest difference in this year's team for you and last year's team?
Oh, without any question, this is a team that relies on their long arms and their quickness defensively. And we're not a big, strong physical team, nor would you shoot it very well. We rely on our defensive skills and our mobility and our ability to create situations with penetration. We're not a screening team. Totally different basketball team than you saw last year here. You got some depth, maybe not as much as last year, but a very close-knit and solid team. Can't really pick out one guy. There's four or five guys averaging double figures. But not a physical imposing team. In fact, we may be the least physical imposing team in this tournament.
I bet you hustle more than anybody else. Scott's back. We're going to have to take this break. We want to thank you for stopping by, John. Wish you the best of luck tonight. And hope we see you again playing here on Saturday night.
Well, we hope so too, Robert.
Thank you. John Spezia, the coach of the DACC Jaguars. And not only is he the coach of the team, but he's got to be the assistant director of the tournament. We'll get Scott Eisenhower in here. Scott, do we go back for a break? All right.
We need to do that. 38-28, our halftime score. Again, the lead belongs to Rhodes State College. We'll take a two-minute break. You're listening to the NJCAA Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Network. Of Rose State College. We'll take a look at some of the team numbers here in just a moment with Mr. Bob Cade. Meanwhile, we get underway with second half action. Wobonzi CC with the basketball. They work right hand side, Osley down low. The feed inside to Sykes. He missed the first opportunity, got a second, missed it as well. The rebound by the Raiders. Up before they come, on the feed, down low. Ogilvy wide open, but he missed it. And the rebound by the Chiefs. The Chiefs in their gold uniforms, trimmed in red and in white. While the Raiders of Rose State College in their navy blues, trimmed in gold and in white. Off to the left-hand side with the basketball. Osley leads Wobonzi to the left-hand side of the forecourt. Now they give to Plank with the three, and it's good. Adam Plank with his first 3 points of the ball game. Some first half numbers.
Okay, first of all, for the Rose State Raiders, they were 14 out of 35 from the field, 4 out of 14 three-pointers, 6 out of 7 free throws. They had 20 rebounds, and they had 6 turnovers. For Wobonzi, they were 12 out of 27 from the field, only 1 out of 4 at three-pointers, 3 out of 6 free throws, and 11 turnovers.
McCleary tried a 3 to counter. He missed it. The rebound by Wobonzi. They got up the floor, and on the baseline drive, Sykes couldn't get the ball to tickle the net. And Rose State College will work in the opposite direction. Now heading towards the west end of Mary Miller Gymnasium. Up top with the ball, Lang. Lang on the cross court. In between the circles, back to Lang. He shoots the three off the front of the rim, and the rebound by the Chiefs. On the outlet they give to the right-hand side. Blank with the ball out beyond the perimeter. Blank down underneath, gives to Osley. Back up top, Blank to the left-hand side, and around they go. Thompson, Blank. Right-hand side, Osley. Osley underneath, can't find anybody. Comes to Griffo, to Osley. Inside to Griffo. He turns, shoots, missed it, and rebound by Rose State College.
Well, the high post looks for the low post on that Chiefs offense. And, they've had a couple of shots in there, and we're going to get a 20-second timeout. And Scott, I think on this timeout, he wants to talk to him about defending that high-low post down there, because the Chiefs get the ball in underneath at about 8 feet, 9 feet from the basket, and then they make that little short lob pass down to about the 2-foot shot. And the coach down here now for the Rose State is talking to him. I'm sure it's about defense.
Dr. Thomas Mills doing a little instructing down there with his team up by 7. Their lead at one point, however, Bob K, was 15. And if there's anything else we've learned from the first two games today, double-digit leads mean absolutely nothing in this tournament. The team earlier today, Platt Campus out of Central Community College in Nebraska, had a 16-point lead and had to almost let it slip away. Then in the second game, played earlier today, a 10-point lead was held by the Lions. They win it by 2.
I was sitting with John Grotenheist, the ex-referee, and we were talking about that Iowa just wouldn't go away, and they hang around, you're going to get close at the end.
A shot from three-point range by Pearson, it was no good, and on the rebounding effort, Coleman is going to pick up a foul for the Raiders of Rose State. That'll be his second, the team's first of the second half.
Scott, I used to refer to the times when I helped Norm Held, and he used to say, and this is no reference to any of the three teams that have been behind today, but he used to always say he hated those teams that weren't good enough to win and weren't bad enough to lose by a lot of points. They just kept the game close all the time.
Rose State on the missed Wabonzi offensive opportunity, and now down low. They'll work on the baseline. Up top to Lang, and Lang is going to be fouled as he drove into the paint. That'll be in the act of shooting, so he'll head to the stripe to shoot two. This foul courtesy of Adam Plank. It'll be his first and the team's first.
And it's going to be.
Now Coach Dave Heiss is trying to convince the officials the foul was on the floor, but they called it in the shot process right from the get-go.
I think he dropped the ball on the floor. It was rolling down along the free throw area when they called the foul, but I think the coach has got a little bit of a complaint there, but it went on deaf ears.
And the first free throw is good. Second free throw on the way. It rolls around and drops through, and Lang's got his first 2 points of the ball game.
Got a shooter's roll on both of those, didn't he?
40-31, the lead by Rose State College into the forecourt. Wabonzi having some trouble. Now coming up with it is going to be Sykes. Sykes will feed it inside. Thompson to Grippo, and the bucket is good.
Great no-look pass that time for Wabonzi by number 44, Thompson.
Rose State inside, trying to feed it. Picked off by Wabonzi, and up before they come. Grippo with the steal. To the right-hand side, Plank. Plank out beyond the perimeter. On the bounce pass down low, and they throw it away. The steal by the Raiders. The bounce pass to the left-hand side, Lang. Lang up beyond the arc. Is going to drive to the baseline. Finds the opening, lays it in, and missed it. Rebound, fought for it. We've got a whistle on the play, and this is going to be a rebounding foul.
In the turnover department for the game, Scott, Wabonzi's got 13, Rose has only 6. They got those 6 in the first half.
Ogilvie picks up the personal foul. That'll be his third and the team's second. Neither team saw the bonus in the first half, Bob K.
These referees kind of let them play. It's been not a rough game, just a physical game.
We're coming up on the top of the hour. In just a moment, we'll give stations an opportunity to identify themselves. And in just a bit. Meanwhile, Wabonzi with the basketball. Osley had some trouble. Now finds Plank, gives it to him. He's going to be double-teamed up top. Rolls to the right, takes it into the paint. Quick dish underneath. Layup, good!
Another excellent pass by the Wabonzi point guard, who drove the right side, got inside. That's Adam Plank, and then dished off.
Sykes with his fourth point of the ball game. 40-35, the Rose State lead cut to 5. up top and around the perimeter. The Raiders work the basketball. They give it to Sullivan. Sullivan on the handoff to Pearson. Pearson in the corner to Lang. His three-pointer in and out. The rebound by the Chiefs. On the outlet to Plank. Plank will bring it across the green stripe in midcourt. Quick feed underneath, inside to Osley, and he lost the handle on the ball, and it's going to be picked up by Rose State College. 15:25 left to go in the game. 40-35, the five-point lead belongs to Rose State. Out to the right-hand side, Lang goes underneath Ogilvy. Ogilvy just outside the paint, works his way. Fakes inside, goes outside, shot doesn't fall. Tip by Coleman Wong, the rebound put back by Coleman Wong, and we've got a whistle on the play. We'll take this opportunity to give stations an opportunity to identify themselves. You're listening to the National Junior College Athletic Association Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Radio Network. Scott Eisenhower and Bob Kaye along with you here from the Mary Miller Gymnasium on the campus of Danville Area Community College in Danville, Illinois. The first free throw attempt by Mike Coleman, no good. Rose State College out of Oklahoma leads Waubonsie Community College out of Illinois 40-35.
Scott, another thing, and we've seen it a lot this year, and Illinois didn't do it very well. Free throw shooting seems to be kind of a lost art. They used to talk about bunting in baseball. Free throw shooting's down in that 60% a lot of teams.
This one goes through. Coleman with 5 points, 41-35. The lead by Rose State. Waubonsie in the forecourt. Double team coverage. They work it off left-hand side. Picked off by Pearson. On the feed, up the floor. The line of the dunk is good. Derek Lang got the feed and slams it through the net to pick up his fourth point of the contest.
15 turnovers in the game for the Chiefs, three in the second half.
Over to the left-hand side with a quick pass. It goes from Thompson inside. They work from Osley to Grippo, and the layup is good. And Grippo with his 12th point of the ball game.
Quick pass by Thompson, shovel pass, underhanded like a softball pitcher's pitch, but it got right to the man.
43-37, Rose State with the lead. Rolling to the right side, Lang. He'll take it in the paint. Has the ball knocked out of his hands. Coleman got it, but he's going to be fouled. And that foul is going to be whistled on Marcus Sykes. That'll be his third, the team's second of the second half.
This will put the big man at the free throw line, and Coleman, 6'4", 200 pounder. See what kind of a touch he's got up there.
Our final game of the day, Bob Kaye, will be Danville Area Community College against Naugatuck Valley Community Technical College.
Was the guy from Naugatuck the one that had the best answer last night on what it took to get here?
I'm not sure where he was from.
It was a ways away. That's why I thought maybe he was the guy.
Asked him last night. They were going around the room at the tip-off banquet, asking each of them a couple of questions. And Bill Yackel asked one of the players, what did it take to get here? Now, some of them said offense. Others said defense. This kid said two planes and a bus. And the second free throw is good. 45-37, the advantage by Rose State. Waubonsie into the forecourt. Lang off to the left-hand side. Gives the ball up. They work to Thompson. Thompson in the paint. Scoop pass underneath to Grippo. He saves it just in time to get it to Flint. Flint is going to be fouled by Sullivan. That'll be his first personal. The team's third.
Well, Scott, he's just a junior college player. I've told you many times, and one of the favorite quotes I heard was Gretzky, when they asked him when the Oilers won the Stanley Cup, when did you know you hadn't won? And he said, without blinking an eye, when we knew that they knew that we knew that they knew. The guy asking that question went to a commercial break. When we knew that they knew that we knew that they knew.
How much clearer could it be?
That's exactly.
Got a good-sized crowd on hand here tonight, starting to fill into the Mary Miller Gymnasium. And, of course, if you're here locally in the area, a great opportunity to come out and see the best junior college basketball in the country. Top 12 teams of the nation. with the basketball. Plank threw it right into traffic, but it bounced right back to him. He'll work it inside to Grippo. Grippo lost a handle on the ball, and it's going to be stripped away by the Raiders. Up the floor they come. Sullivan to the right-hand side, out beyond the arc. On the cross-court feed to Lang. Lang alley-oops down low to Coleman. Coleman on the baseline, working his way into the paint. Stops, has it stripped away, and he traveled.
16 turnovers now for the Chiefs in the ball game, four in the second half.
45-37, the advantage belongs to Rose State. Chiefs off to the left-hand side. Work the ball to Clint. Clank, now Thompson. Thompson, double team. Call a timeout. And he needs to discuss this with his team, and Dave Ice will agree. It'll be a 30. We'll keep it here. 13-27 to play in this second half of basketball. 45-37, Rose State on top.
Scott Thompson called timeout right here in front of us, and he had a very interesting comment. He'd gotten trapped with the timeline to his back and the out-of-bounds line out here in front of us. He called timeout when he was double-teamed, and then he immediately said to his players, somebody's got to get here, come to me. That is exactly right. Four of his players were spread around the floor, but nobody came to help him. He said, man, somebody's got to come help me, and he pointed to the spot on the floor where he wants help. So he's a coach on the floor. He knows what they got to do to break the press. And knows where the guy's got to be.
Earlier today, two games were played. Central Community College Platt Campus was a winner over Lackawanna Junior College, 66-64. And Community College of Baltimore County Dundalk was a winner over Iowa Lakes Community College, 88-86. Now an over-the-back call against the Chiefs of Waubonsie Community College, and Rose State will get it back. Off to the right-hand side with the dribble. Sullivan beyond the arc. Now looks, cross-courts at left-hand side, Lang. Lang looks to the paint, now has to pull back out. Comes across the top, Coleman. Right-hand side, Sullivan in between the rounds. They give the ball now to Johnson. Johnson to Sullivan for a three, and it's no good. And the rebound by the Chiefs. On the outlet, they give to Plank. Plank at the right-hand side of the floor. Dumps it off. Flint back to Plank. Back to Flint. Flint now will hold. 12:48 left to go here in the contest. 45-37. Waubonsie trails with the basketball. Flint, Plank. Shot clock at 13. They go down low. Thompson, baseline layup, no good. And the rebound picked up by Rose State. Flair in the house will be Johnson.
Thompson not happy that he missed that shot right underneath. He had a pretty good shot at it and hurried it because he thought he was going to get fouled or at least blocked on the shot.
Rose State works the perimeter to the free throw line. They give to Lang, fakes the three. He'll drive into the paint. Eight-footer is no good, but he's fouled from behind, and this will come against Irving Richardson.
I'll tell you, Scott, if Derek Lang wears that sweatband around his head any lower, he'd be blind. It's down to about his eyebrows right now.
Well, I thought that about some of the guys' shorts earlier today. There were a couple of guys I was concerned whether or not we were going to have to get suspenders for them.
I'd be tempted in guarding this guy to reach up and pull that sweatband down just a little bit and be over his eyes.
When I played, I'm sure they created rules against this now, Bob, but when I played, we'd gather around that free throw line and we'd reach over and just lightly grab the guy's shorts next to us. So when he went up to jump, we'd tug on him a little bit. Second free throw is good. Lang with 6 points. Some of those guys earlier today wouldn't take it much.
No, it wouldn't.
47-37, 10-point lead for Rose State. Back to double digits. Their largest lead has been 15. Waubonsie whittled away at that here in the second half. Richardson with the ball for the gold-clad Chiefs. On the baseline, pulls up, shoots, won't go. Rebound by the Raiders. To the other side of the gym we go. Johnson into the forecourt. He'll bring it up. Now works left-hand side. Lang, Coleman on the baseline. Coleman, quick feet across court. McCleary with a three. Up the front of the rim and it won't go. Rebound by Waubonsie. Griffel to the right side, Osley down underneath Richardson. Richardson, Stern shoots, has the ball stripped out of his hands, and it's going to be picked off by Rose State. To the right hand side, they work it. Johnson on the bounce pass, Coleman. Up top they give. Cole, jumper, won't fall. Rebound by Waubonsie. Blank
across the midcourt stripe. Now he slows down the offense. Kiss off right-hand side, free throw line extension. Richardson now left-hand side. They work, back up top flank. Right-hand side, Richardson on the baseline. He's got an opener, missed the shot, but he's fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Scott, in the last about 2.5, 3 minutes, both teams gone pretty cold. They've been stuck at 47-37 and missed some pretty good shots, really.
Our halftime score was 38-28. So they haven't scored but 9 each here in the second half. 10:55 left to play in the game.
Two guys waiting here for Munsey to come in. See if they both get in or if one of them's coming in for the free throw shooter. He is.
Richardson knocks down the first one. He's got 3 points.
Now they're revolving all around with the substitute that came in. Who gets the key place along the free throw line on the rebound to the free throw?
Second free throw, no good, but the Chiefs with the rebound. They kick back outside, and the three is up and good for Richardson. He's got 6 points.
Richardson missed the free throw from 15 feet and got the long rebound, made a basket throw by 18 feet.
That off the assist by Thompson. And Dr. Mills wants a timeout. 10:43 left to go in the game. 47-41, Rose State with the lead. You're listening to the National Junior College Athletic Association Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Network.
Bob K, you had the opportunity to eavesdrop a little bit on Dave Heiss. What's the game plan from here?
He's kind of a volatile coach, and he's a very expressive coach. This time he was just drawing up an offensive play, what they're going to do on offense and how they're going to try to get a man open underneath.
To the right-hand side, Raiders with the basketball, and the ball was knocked out of play by the Wabonzi defense. Thompson, who's really picked up his game here in the last couple of minutes, Bob K.
Thompson's one of those guys that doesn't look like a basketball player. He's tall, but he's kind of heavy set. Looks like he might be more of a tackle. But boy, he works hard.
McCleary with the Rose State ball. Gives it off to Cole, and Cole won it across the other end of the floor and out of play. That is their first turnover of the second half.
7 for the game, first one this half. And it was a turnover. That looked like a McGuire home run into about the second row of the upper deck.
Chiefs with the ball. Thompson on the no look inside. It bounces around, ends up in the hands of Osley, and the bucket is good. He's got 4, and the Chiefs are within 4.
I think that's what Coach Heiss wanted to do, is work the ball down low, double post, high low post, and get the ball in underneath.
McCleary to Cole. Outside and around they go from Pearson to Johnson, and his three-point shot no good, and the Chiefs with the rebound, and we've got an official's timeout as a player got hit in the eye. That player is Thompson.
He went up to get the rebound, and when the guy went by him, was not in good position, just took a swipe at getting the rebound and hit him right, I think, in the eye, maybe in the nose, but I think it was more the eye, but he's all right now. And the player went down and shook his hand. The player for Rose was Derek Pearson, and they shook hands, but it was just one of those wild swings to try to get a ball.
Well, these two teams have both shown great sportsmanship throughout the course of the night. There's just another example. Wabonzi with the basketball to the left-hand side. They'll get up top to Plank, to Sykes on the cross court to Flint. Flint in the paint is going to be fouled.
Wayne Baker told me that Duke College of DuPage, who's up in this area, who was down here a couple of years ago and got second in the Division II national tournament, this year got second in the Division III national tournament. And I expect they play Waubonsie. I expect that's a pretty good rivalry.
On the inbound to the left side, they go from Sykes to Osley, and the layup is good. He's got six. And the Chiefs have worked it down to a deuce.
Scott, since that timeout, you asked me what they were doing. They've gotten two layups on good passing.
9:25 left to go here in this contest. 47-45, Rose State with a two-point lead. Up top, they give to Armstrong. Armstrong up to the left-hand side. Puts the ball to Pearson. Pearson up top. Dribbles out of traffic. Right-hand side, hands off Johnson. Johnson in the paint, one-handed scoop shot, rolls around and drops through. Johnson with his first 2 points, Bob K.
And I'd say they were a lucky team.
At the middle of the floor, the ball was stripped away, and McCleary is going to be called for the foul.
Well, no argument out of McCleary. He thought he had a clean steal, but obviously he got a piece of the arm going by.
And now Griffel will check back into the lineup for Dave Heiss. Coming out, Brian Flint. 49-45, Chiefs down by four. 8:55 left to go here in the contest. Plank out on the left-hand side with the ball, lost the handle and out of bounds. No force there, he just couldn't hang on to it.
That's the sixth turnover this half and the 18th in the game. One of the officials there, we're going to get a 20-second timeout, so we'll call here. The referee that called the timeout is a young man from Champaign. Well, he's, I'm not going to say he's a young man anymore, but Sam Banks. Sam came to town over at Champaign, and he was the administrator, chief administrator for the Cunningham Home, and I was athletic director in Danville. He called me, and he said, I'd like to get into refereeing here. He said, I refereed a lot wherever he had come from. And I said, well, we're really all booked up for this year. And I was trying to hesitate him and Hawn. We haven't seen him, and I wanted to be sure. And he said, well, I've done a couple of high school games in Pennsylvania or California, wherever you come from. And he said, I did some junior college games. So wasn't a week went by. And one of our referees called and said he was giving up refereeing. He'd had a contract for a couple of years, wouldn't make it. So I called Sam and said, I've got a game for you. Told Garley, and he said, oh, guys, you're going to hire a guy we don't know, never seen before. I was Bloomington or something. I said, well, he was available, and it's pretty late in the, you know, in the spring or in the fall, and yeah, we're going to. Well, Sam was one of the best we had all year. Garley said, get that guy again next year. He's pretty good. So I've known Sam. That was about 1982, 81, 82, 83. So Sam's been around a while, but he got into the Big 12 just on a chance. Somebody got sick, and he was there.
Well, in fact, Sam is making a return trip here to the NJCAA National Tournament.
Well, after almost causing Garley to have a heart attack, it's nice to see him back.
Rose State with the basketball. 8:35 left to go in the game. 49-45. Rose State with the four-point lead. They work it around the perimeter. An outside jumper by Johnson. His three-point shot bounces around. Won't ball through. McCleary comes out of the pile with the ball. Across the top of the arc, McCleary with a bounce pass. Coleman wide open baseline, but he's going to be called for the charge on a nice defensive effort by Thompson. And Coleman had an opening on the baseline, Bob Cave, but he chose to go inside instead of outside, and because of that, he's going to be whistled for the charge.
Yep, if he'd remember earlier in the game, when I think it was Richardson made a reverse pivot and got a layup, if he'd have made the same move down here, he'd have got the basket and wouldn't have got the foul.
49-45. Now the Chiefs have an opportunity to get it back down to two or one. Middle of the floor. Osley with the ball. Gives it. Griffo fakes. Now shoots. Rolls around. Won't ball. Rebound. Sykes. Put back. Good.
Well, that was a big rebound by Sykes because he was dead right underneath the basket. He had to make him work his way around. He made it a hard shot. A right-hander off the left side.
Coleman with the ball for Rose State. Still up by two. Gives it in the middle to Pearson. Pearson with some trouble on the handle. Now comes up with it. Dumps it off to Johnson. Johnson on the drive. Had it knocked out of his hands. Now comes up with it. Shoots and scores. He's got four.
Well, that was the second time that Thompson got knocked down. I think that was more of an offensive foul there than the one along the baseline.
51-47. he throws it away.
And Coach Heist, he didn't see Judd Heathcote do that, did he?
No, I'll tell you what, the difference is Heist caught it.
Yeah.
Twice he did that and caught it both times.
Both times. I'm glad he caught it. He was right in front of me.
It is safe to say there's some air in that basketball.
Yeah. A dent floor right there.
7:17 remains to play here in this contest. Rose State with the ball and a lead. They'll go inside, and Armstrong was hung. You talk about getting a bear hug. My goodness. Some states, they'd be legally married by now, Bob K, yeah, with a big hug like that.
Thompson got caught out of position, and to keep him from getting the basket, just gave him a big hug, and they're going to get it out of bounds, but they didn't get a basket.
Armstrong gets the inbounds all the way up top. Works it off to the left-hand side, Johnson. Johnson back upstairs. Armstrong out of the right side, Pearson. Pearson pulls across the top of the arc, hands off McCleary. Right side, Johnson. Johnson pulls out deep beyond the arc. Ogilvy, McCleary. McCleary over in the corner. Pearson, Ogilvy, right side, Johnson. Johnson's going to drive to the free throw line, kicks off left-hand corner, three-pointer is good for Pearson. He's got 15.
I like that little jump shot Pearson's got when he's squared up to the basket.
Well, and I'll tell you what,
still in the back court, a lot of pressure. Now we get into the front court.
Left-hand side, Chiefs with the ball. They give to Plank in the middle. Dumps down into the corner, side shot. Rose State.
Rose State gets down to 2 or 3 points, and it's kind of like they wake up. Wabonzi sends them wake-up call, and they wake up playing spurts.
Out right-hand side, Thompson with the basketball. Across the top, they give to McCleary. McCleary on the baseline drive, missed the shot, tips around, won't fall, and the rebound now by Wabonzi Community College. Griffin cleans the glass, and they'll work it up the floor. 5:45 left to go in the game, 54-47. Wabonzi trails. They go inside. Griffo blocked away by Ogilvy and the rebound by Rose State.
Two shots in a row at Wabonzi right underneath 3, 4, 5 feet, and both of them blocked.
Across the timeline to the top of the key. McCleary gives off right-hand side. They'll bring it up top. Armstrong, left-hand baseline. Pearson, McCleary. Almost threw it away, trying to get it to Johnson. Ogilvy, McCleary, in the corner, Pearson. He'll pull up, 18-footer, in and out, doesn't fall. Armstrong's tip won't go, and the rebound by the Chiefs. And Dave Heist wants a timeout. 5:07 left to go here in the game. 54-47, the lead belongs to the Raiders of Rose State College. You're listening to the National Junior College Athletic Association Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Network. State College. Their lead has been as great as 15 points. Wabonzi has never led in this ball game, although they've been within two or four through a better part of this second half of play, Bob King.
Yeah, they just don't throw away, but it appears that Rose has enough talent that they just kind of turn it on when they get close. Here's a turnover.
Here's an example of that, and Rose State is going to strip away the basketball. Johnson into the forecourt. Takes it from the Chiefs. They work right-hand side. From Lang to McCleary, underneath to Armstrong. He'll clear, Johnson, back up top to Lang. 4:40 left to go in the game. 7-point lead for Rose State. Lang out on the right-hand side. Fires it up top. Ogilvy, left-hand side. Three on the way. It is no good by Johnson, and the rebound by Wabonzi. The ball is going to be picked off by McCleary. And Rose State has the ball back.
8 turnovers this half and 15 in the game.
Well, it's just like you said, Bob. Every time Wabonzi does something right, Rose State turns around and counteracts it.
Yep. I really don't know that I've seen in a long time a team that plays, they kind of get lackadaisical and like right there. Bounce pass right into the Chiefs' hands.
And Wabonzi up the floor with the basketball on the turnaround and shot by Richardson. It won't fall. The rebound goes out of play. And it'll belong to the Chiefs of Wabonzi CC underneath their own. With 3:52 left to go in the game.
He didn't even telegraph that pass. He just passed it into the guy's hands from Wabonzi, and they make some plays like that, kind of lackadaisical, and then they come back and just do something really physical and well.
Inbounding the basketball, Plank will bring it into Richardson. Richardson back down low to Plank. Plank will roll across the top in between the circles. Looks off to the left-hand side, dribbles off to the right. Richardson on the feed underneath. Gets it to Thompson, back up Richardson. To Plank, fakes the three. Back into the corner it goes. Richardson with a three, missed it off the side of the rim, and the rebound by Rose State. 3:23 left to go in the game. 54-47, the Rose State lead. Raider basketball to the right-hand side. McCleary. Across the top, Ogilvy, Lang, and now Pearson. Back up top, Lang. On the dribble to the right-hand side. Hands the ball off to McCleary. McCleary to Pearson. Pearson almost punted the ball into the stands. 5 seconds on the shot clock. He'll dribble to the left, feeds in the corner. Ogilvy, three, it is no good. Rebound underneath by Armstrong. Rose State will maintain control. Boy, they go 35 seconds.
That was a big rebound there because it gave them another 35 seconds on the clock.
Huge rebound. McCleary out on the right-hand side. Takes it into the paint. Dumps down. Big flag dump by Ogilvy. And we're going to have a foul. The dunk and the horn.
Well, there were a lot of players between us and the man that broke the baseline, but he didn't step. The guy drove down the middle of the free throw line and gave him the pass. Ogilvy was flying out of that right-hand corner, and I never saw him bounce the ball. I don't think he could get from where he caught it to where he dunked it without even stepping. If he didn't, he's got a cape that's got a big S on it somewhere. He flew a long way.
Able to lay the ball up in a single bound.
I guess.
The free throw is good. Ogilvy with the dunk and the extra for the old-fashioned three-point play. He's got 13.
That's not very old-fashioned. I never saw many guys dunk it.
10-point difference. 2:20 left to go in the game. Plank, left-hand side, works the ball off to Flynn, and I mean now. It has really gotten rough, Bob Kay.
Yes, it has gotten very, very physical, and you know it's going to because 10 points, you're not out of the ball game, and the Chiefs are going to try to get it and push it down the floor as fast as they can, and the Rose wants, of course, to play good defense, not let them get a shot away, and then run as much time off as they can. So both teams, the object of the thing for both teams is to keep possession of the ball.
Free throw on the way by Flynn is no good off the front of the rim. The rebound put back is no good, and the Chiefs still trying to get control. Lose the handle, and Armstrong will pick it up for Rose State.
Missed a chance to score when the clock stopped, and then missed a chance on a tip-in right under the basket.
McCleary to the right side, Armstrong. Up top, they give to Lang across the perimeter to Pearson. Pearson holds, and it's going to be picked off. Picked off by Richardson, but he couldn't come up with the ball, and it's now retaken by McCleary to the right-hand side. Underneath the two-minute warning of the ball game, 57-47. Rose State with the lead. The ball, Pearson on the drive. Count the bucket, and they're going to call the foul. Underneath on the Chiefs of Wabonzi CC.
Well, that's the old-fashioned three-point. It'd be a drive-in and get fouled on it, but I haven't seen a lot of guys dunk in my lifetime and get fouled, too. That's a semi-old-fashioned.
Going to the line, Pearson. Morrison, 17 points on the ball game, and he'll try to make it 18. And now the lead back to double figures for the Raiders of Rose State. The free throw is good.
Scott, that ball hit on the front side of the front rim. Looked like it was going to be short and dropped straight down, bounced up and bounced in. Talk about a shooter's balance.
60-47, Rose State with the lead. Wilbonsi with the ball and a 1:40 to play. Here's a three on the way, and it is good by Brian Flint. He's got 8 points.
Up, good. Take timeout.
Well, I think Coach,
he was signaling he wanted a diamond defense, and I think Sam Banks mistook that for a timeout.
So that's exactly what they'll do. Give the ball back to Rose State, let him run the line, and now they inbound the ball. Armstrong to Pearson, back to Armstrong, now to Lang. Lang into the forecourt. On the bounce pass down low, McCleary is going to be double teamed. Dumps it to Lang, he is going to be fouled from behind. To the line to shoot two. This will be courtesy of Richardson, and that's his third personal foul. But find out before the next time Rose State plays, Bob K, what the gentleman's name is, but the bus driver for the Raiders of Rose State also serves as their chief cheerleader. If you watch him in the stands, he is up and down like a yo-yo over there.
Well, that's great that the guy can have that kind of loyalty to the team. A lot of the sometimes employees bring you there or work there and you never see them until they're back again at the end of the game or time to pick you up or time to lock the doors, but it's always great. We had a guy at Danville High, Mike Fitzwater, that was that way. He was head custodian tonight. Boy, he was the greatest Danville fan. He was at the end of the gym cheering you on.
Yeah, that's what this guy does. He, in fact, he's a character. I got a chance to talk to him a little bit earlier today. He's a fun guy. 62-50, both free throws were made. Rose State with the lead, 1:18 to play. Plank with the ball, gets it into the Wabonzi corner, in and out of the hands of Flint, loose on the floor, and Rose State's gonna strip it away. Up to the right-hand side, and a foul by Plank. McCleary will go to the line. 22 turnovers by Wabonzi Community College, 9 for the Raiders of Rose State.
You've got that kind of a differential. It's surprising you're only 12 behind.
Well, and remember, this was a contest that the Raiders led by 15, and Wabonzi cut to 2 at one point, but I think that kind of took the energy out of them. McCleary with the first free throw, he's got 9.
They put in so much effort to cut it down, and Rose State has just really pressed them the whole game and been so tough on defense that I expect they're a little leg weary, a little tired.
Second free throw on the way is up and good. And Cleary's in double figures with 10. 64-50. The lead by Rose State. 65 seconds to go. Flint to Plank. Now into the forecourt. Works it off left-hand side. Cross court to Flint. Flint shoots the three. Short off the side of the rim. Rebound underneath by the Chiefs. They kick it out to the corner. Another three ball by Flint. Won't fall. This time Rose State with the rebound. Coleman clears. Gives to Pearson. To Coleman. To McCleary. McCleary off to the right-hand side. Needs to get it across the timeline, and they don't do it in 10 seconds. Felt as though they had all day back there, Bob K.
Yeah, and they got near the timeline over here, right here on the left side in front of us. And that was Mike Coleman, and he didn't take it over the line. He passed back behind him to McCleary, and when he did that, then they had trouble getting it in. Now they're going to get the steal anyway, and right back again to the Chiefs.
Turnover begets turnover, and Matt Brown ended up with the ball, gets the turnaround bucket. He's got his first 2 points. 28 seconds left to go, a timeout on the floor. Let's quickly take it. 64-52, Rose State leads. You're listening to the NJCAA Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Network. State with the ball. They're going to lob it into the backcourt. 21 seconds to go in the game. Wabonzi with a three. Flint missed it, and we've got an over-the-back call. This one's going to be whistled on Matt Brown, and we will walk down and shoot free throws. And this one will pretty much be in the books, Bob K. The victory for Rose State College will advance them into tomorrow night's championship bracket, where they'll take on Aiken Technical College.
Scott, this last timeout, they called the timeout, talked it over, and Coach Dave Heiss sent his team back out on the floor. His scorer, team scorer, sitting right beside me, he looked at both of us, took a long pull on a water out of a water bottle, and said we just couldn't get over the hump. Right? And that pretty well sums it up. They could get close, but they just couldn't get over the hump, and he realizes it as a coach.
65-52, the 13-point lead. McCleary knocks down the first free throw. He's got a second one on the way. This one is up, and it is good as well. He'll finish with 12. In the backcourt, the Chiefs inbound the ball. 15 seconds will roll off the clock. Out to the right side, Richardson. He'll shoot the three ball. It is in and out. No good. Rebound by Rose State, and they're just going to hold the ball for the final 2 seconds. This one is over, and Rose State, a 66-52 winner over the Chiefs of Wabonzi Community College. Let's take a 2-minute break. You're listening to the NJCAA Division II Men's Basketball National Tournament Network.